YouTube channel. This is the fourth lecture of our transportation engineering. In the previous lectures, we have covered the module 1, that is the introduction part. From today's lecture, we are going to start the module 2, that is the design of a highway. Okay, so in the design of a highway, we will first start with the pavement characteristic. In the pavement characteristic, the first topic is friction. So we will see this. So what is a friction? We all know that the friction is a resisting force that provide resistance to the motion of object moving relative to another. Means if the object is moving in this direction, then the frictional force will be acting opposite to the direction of motion. Okay, so the friction is divided into the two part, that is acting longitudinally is known as the longitudinal friction, and the friction which acting laterally is known as the lateral friction. Here we will see the longitudinal friction. We see the longitudinal friction in the straight road. When the car is or the any vehicle is moving in the longitudinal direction, then frictional force plays a role in the opposite direction of the motion of the vehicle. So this is the case of a longitudinal friction on the straight road. But when the vehicle is moving on some curve, then in that case the lateral friction plays a role. Lateral friction acting inward direction of the curve, and the centrifugal force acting opposite to the direction of the friction. These are the two types of a friction, that is a longitudinal friction and the lateral friction. We will see the value of a longitudinal friction as per the speed. This is the table for the longitudinal friction coefficient that depends upon the speed of the vehicle. So when the speed of vehicle is less than 30 km per hour, the value of frictional coefficient is 0.4, and when the speed is 40 km per hour, the value is 0.38. when the speed is 50 km per hour, so the friction coefficient value is 0.37, and when the speed is 60 km per hour, the value is 0.36, and when the speed is greater than 80 km per hour, the value of frictional coefficient is greater than 80 km per hour, the value of longitudinal friction coefficient is 0.35. And so this is the table for the longitudinal friction coefficient depending upon the speed of a vehicle. It ranges from 0.4 to 0.35 depending upon the speeds. And in the case of lateral friction, its value is 0.15 on a horizontal curve. Okay, so this is the value of lateral friction, and this is the value of longitudinal friction that plays on a straight road, and this is happen in a case of horizontal curve. So next we will see the second part of a pavement characteristic, that is a skidding and slipping. So this is the second part of a pavement characteristic, the skidding and slipping. So first we will see about the skidding. What is skidding? So skidding is when the path traveled is greater than the circumferential movement, it is called skidding. Okay, so in simple way we can understand, when the path traveled is greater than the circumferential movement, it is known as the skidding. And what is slipping? Slipping is the opposite of a skidding. Means when the path traveled is less than the circumferential movement, it is called as a slipping. Simpler way we can understand that when the path traveled by the wheel is greater than the circumferential movement, it is known as the skidding. And when the path traveled by the wheel is lesser than the circumferential movement, it is known as the slipping. Next we will see the third part of the pavement characteristic, that is the pavement unevenness. What is pavement unevenness? See what is a pavement unevenness. If this is any pavement, let us suppose this is any pavement, this is the center line of that pavement, this is the top view of the pavement. Okay, but if we see from the side view, this is the upper surface of the pavement, and if there is some unevenness, means there is some undulation or unevenness in the pavement, we can measure it by the instrument known as the bump indicator. Okay, so it is measured by the bump indicator. Okay, so by the bump indicator we can measure the unevenness in the pavement. So we will classify the unevenness into the three categories. The first one is the बेस्ट कैटेगरी, सेकेंड वन इज द अनसेटिस्फैक्ट्री कैटेगरी, थर्ड वन इज द सेटिस्फैक्ट्री कैटेगरी. ओके सो आई विल राइट हियर undulations and here I will write the pavement category. As per the undulations, the pavement is categorized into the three categories. If the undulation is less than 150 centimeter per kilometer, the pavement is categorized as the best. When the undulation is 250 centimeter per kilometer, the pavement is categorized as a satisfactory. And when the undulation is greater than 350 centimeter per kilometer, the pavement is categorized as a unsatisfactory. So this is about the pavement unevenness. This is all about today's lecture. In the next lecture, we will see the second part after the pavement characteristics, that is the camber. Hope you have enjoyed it. Thank you.